the Islanders able to advance. Noah Dobson for Matt Barzal. Barzal, wrist shot swallowed up by Thatcher Demko.
A nice rush there by Noah Dobson.
Since Rick Tocchet took over as head coach in the middle of last season, that's the seventh best record in the NHL since he came in, as Palmieri taps one around the back of the net for Brock Nelson. Strip it away from Friedman, and he does. Wahlstrom comes away with it. Centering feed for Matt Martin. Couldn't direct it on goal. Now Ryan Pulock cruising in. Backdoor play, and Demko, a sensational save on Wahlstrom.
Are you kidding me with that stretch to the right? And this is where you get that winning percentage up pretty high when you get saves like this one here. Demko's going to go to his left. Here. Now he's going to shuffle and push with his left skate and somehow do the splits and make that first save. And it is an absolute beauty right there.
He was so far to the one side to look around the screen in front. Great movement.
Clean faceoff win. Romanov shot swallowed up by Thatcher Demko, the 24-year-old. Little spin move on Brock Nelson. Mikheyev drives into the crease. Pushed on goal. Sorokin a save as the rebound went back through the crease. Rolls towards the boards. Islanders starting with the second power play unit here as Wahlstrom shot blocked in front. Came to Engvall. He'll set it again. Engvall snaps it over for Wahlstrom. Wahlstrom, Engvall, loads up, shoots, scores! Pierre Engvall with Anders Lee parked in front of the Islanders. Strike first on the power play.
Yeah, quick wrist shot there that found its way through the penalty kill unit. And just barely, it doesn't take much. Puck's not that big. Right through the goaltender. Engvall sets up on the left side after they move to the right side. And then dot to dot right there. And that's one of the things that we talked about with the penalty kill. It went off the stick of Dakota Joshua right there. He's trying to get in the way up top on the right side. You'll see him go out. And it's going one way and it zips past the opposite direction as it glances off the shaft of the stick right there.
But Panger, right, we were talking to Tocchet this morning. He said that was one area of the PK he felt.
Islanders win the faceoff. And they come right to the net. It's Palmieri shut down on the post by Demko.
Demko didn't cheat there.
Thompson, Nelson steps, shoots, backhand, scores! Brock Nelson on the power play. Two power play goals for the Islanders here in the first half of the first period. A minute and 22 seconds apart.
Got to win that faceoff, and that's exactly what Horvat did. He got real low, strong lower hand, wins it back cleanly. The first attempt by Kyle Palmieri trying to get the goaltender to cheat off the pipe. He does not do so, and it goes to the other side. The shot, the save, and somehow this goes back between the legs on the shot that was blocked originally. Nelson just puts it to the front of the net, ends up taking a glance and going right in. Let's take a closer look here. Raul right off the stick right there of Quinn Hughes. That's how it got up in the air.
But that's great puck movement by the Islanders.
Hughes able to keep it away from Cizikas and keep it alive. Pettersson with a good look. Backdoor play for Kuzmenko. It's off his stick and wide. Kuzmenko, Pettersson. Pettersson across. Meller, and he scores! The Canucks respond with a power play goal of their own, and it's 2-1.
Oh, that is an all-world shot. You talked about a strong lower left-hand angle, and this power play looked like it was slowing down. Looked like it was getting bogged down a little bit, holding on to it a little bit too long, but what a keeping by Hughes. I mean, Cizikas thinks he might be able to whack it out. He doesn't. Here's the play, the first one, and it's not redirected into the back door. This is the play of all plays here. I mean, what a shot. Jennifer, I'm not sure if he thought it was in right away.
Oh, but that was... I mean, look at those two passes that Pettersson made. The one that they just missed down low by Kuzmenko, follows it up seconds.
Reaching at it was Horvat. And Quinn Hughes, a little burst of speed, but he gave it away. Barzal with the steal. Horvat looks, waits, returns it one more, and he scores! Bo Horvat back in Vancouver finds the back of the net. And a big smile for the former Canuck captain.
Zone. And you can see that there's the one spin right there. Then he went to bank it off the boards, and Barzal read it beautifully. Now you go dot to dot right here. Oh, what a play by Barzal to give it back to him. Man, that's a good play. And Horvat's waiting for it. Barzal doesn't have it on his stick for a split second, and it's right back over to Horvat. And that's how you play a fast game with that kind of give and go like that.
Now off to the blue line. Work to Pettersson. Return. Hughes opens up. Kuzmenko with a blast. Off the glass, but not out of the zone. Kept in by the backhand of Quinn Hughes. Final 25 on the Dobson minor. JT Miller feathered in front, and Besser scores. What a setup and finish. JT Miller to Brock Besser, another power play goal tonight.
Side, that's when you look for the one-timer, because Besser's the right-hand shot, and this is a perfect pass and a great shot. And obviously, Horvat doesn't collapse down low just nearly quick enough. It's a good pass by Miller. It's in a small area of the ice, and Besser's got an incredible release. He's got great hands, and that was a good example of it right there.
And just before that pass was made, Panger, Pettersson cut through the low slot area.
Pettersson, Hronek returns it. Pettersson from the goal line. Now Hronek, 25 left on the power play. Hughes dusts it off and gives to Besser. Besser to Hughes, switching places with Hronek. Fire scores! Philip Hronek blasts it through, and it's tied at three. All three Canuck goals on the power play.
So 10 goals now for the D of the Vancouver Canucks. And you can see it took them a little while to get things settled, and then the switch finally, Jennifer, where they get a one-timer, and he got all of this, boy. With Miller as a screen, Sorokin can't find it. There's not a chance in the world you're going to be able to see that one.
Well, exactly. Kuzmenko out, and it's Miller now, right, who was the one in front, and he was in just the right spot to make sure Sorokin couldn't track.
Aho fired ahead off Paul Mary. Demko out of his net. Turned over, and it got back in time. He gave it away to Palmieri, and somehow Demko made the save. An open net, he wasted no time, and Demko stretching out to get back, keeps this game all tied at three.
And wants to make something happen. You just have to develop.
Here's Anders Lee on the doorstep, and it's on the goal line, and a goal saved by Ian Cole.
And there... Now, Cole had to really adjust because the post looked like it got in his way at the beginning. Cole's on the bottom of your screen, and he easily could have just whacked it.
Able to skate it ahead, flip it around Dobson. Engvall, Dobson, bolt over, skated, pass to the slot. 6 seconds to go. Tyler Myers over for Bluger. That one trickling to the net. Besser, a couple of chances denied at the horn, and this game is headed to overtime. And Brock Besser, who has scored his 13th goal of the season tonight, tied for the league lead in that category. Miller. Oh. And it's Quinn Hughes getting lost behind the D, and he wins it! Quinn Hughes all along wins it in overtime!
All alone is right. Looked like just a natural regroup.
Crossed him. Again, they were patient with the puck. Besser takes his time, little bank pass, and this is where they slow down a bit, and then all of a sudden, nobody's got the coverage. Wow. He was all alone, and beautiful shot up by.
Well, the New York Islanders got puck watching, and you see the way Miller turned his hand over like that? I mean, just wonderful execution right there, and he disguised it well enough, and he knew exactly where Hughes was, didn't want the Islanders to know, and he put it right on the tape. And thanks for coming, Rick Tocchet, a happy camper with his coaching staff.
Well, the Canucks seemingly can do no wrong at this point. They improve to 12-3-1. They come from down 2-0, score three power play goals to tie it, and then win it on that shot from Quinn Hughes.